Welcome back to Ted's Shed. Today I need to replace the bottom bush on my rear shock absorber. I went to take the shocks off a little while ago. Top one pulled off, bottom one pulled off, and left the rubber mount still attached to the swinging arm. So I need to get that off and replace the bushes on there today. Two bolts. As you can see, that's not meant to be like that. You can see the bush still attached to the swinging arm and the sleeve. So that's what I need to replace that bush. Top one looks fine, literally just the bottom one. So let's crack on and get that bush off. Okay, let's give it a little bit of penetrating fluid. Coming off slowly. Shouldn't be like this would come off, but it's off now. Okay, so now at the bench, I've given the bottom bush of the shock absorber a bit of a clean out. Put any of this shit out of it. And then what I've done is this is the new bush rubber mount. Just stood it in some hot water just to try and make it a little bit easier to get the collar into. In fact, I'll show you this rubber bush when it goes in there. Initially it looks like it's not going to fit properly, which at the moment it doesn't. but once this collar is pushed into there, it will start to expand. Let's pop it in some boiling water, try and soften it up a bit. Minutes makes it a bit easier to soften it. Easier. I find it's easier to get to start this off like that, then pop that one into there. Now, there's several ways you can do this. You could use set of clamps, G clamp. I haven't got one spare at the moment. You could use a bearing inserter tool, or simply do what I'm going to do. Try it again so you can see it. Drop them. Bob's your uncle and Fanny's your aunt. And I can go back on the bike now. So, shock absorber can now go back on the bike. A little bit of copper grease on that stud. Stop it from seizing. And on the top one, don't need very much. Get that off. On. And last thing to do is just make sure these nuts are done up to the correct torque settings. Job done. Just thought I'd bring it up speed. When I took this bush off, although it was a bit of a bugger to get it to come off because the sleeve was stuck onto the swinging arm, it came off in one piece. When I've done the other side, this was well and truly stuck on, seized on, so I had to cut the rubber off to then be able to get a set of mold grips onto it to finally get it off. But it's off, and just bear in mind they won't always come off easily.